What? That's like a sick building.
One man. One game.
One vision. It still sounds like a coffee. I can't... if we go into Costa Coffee and order one of those, I wonder what we would get. I really do. So we've got Joel Vogels on screen for Downforce Racing, scraping across the floor. Not sure if he's got a puncher or not, but when I last saw him, he was off the track. So, which really isn't anything new. And because Stephen Poobles is actually unlapping himself, I assume that he is in trouble.
We have had a couple of driver swaps now, actually. Espen Tippel is now behind the wheel again for the R4R Massive P2 car.
Uh-oh.
And Andreas Löffler did take over for Gregory De Grief in the Black Rebels P2 car.
De Grief.
De Grief is on fire.
So,
and Löffler is having trouble.
And Stephen Peebles has also taken over the LSD Racing GT2 car from Mr. Cox, whom I don't remember the first name of. Was it Kevin?
Kevin.
Yeah.
Is that ISD or LSD?
LSD. It's a small L.
Oh, okay.
I've been told.
That explains so much.
That explains the colours of it, does it?
And I have called it ISD the entire time, so I do apologise. Never mind, but Stephen is still going in 24th position, 28 laps down, doing a fine job.
That's so. Orgels is on his way into the pits.
Yeah, and it's at least puncture on the front left, and it kind of looks like it's a puncture on the rear left as well.
Oh.
You don't have a front bumper as usual.
Rinus Jansen's been off. Let's see if I can get a replay of that. I think he... Oh, no, there he is! Doink!
I think he had a puncture before the crash.
He did, because he's been... He was off the track beforehand. I'm trying to get a... Why is it not letting me replay? Ah, that's why. Okay, let's replay it, if I can. Dun-dun-dun. No, it's not going to let me. That's annoying. See, but so unfortunately, replays are a bit annoying. But Yanis there on his way back to the pits for rare endurance. That's a shame. We've not seen much of them. And then whenever I say we've not seen much of them, and I click to them, they have drama. So maybe it's best that I just ignore them entirely. Oh, is he going to make it? He's in the wall again. Oh dear.
But you know what? I have to leave you guys again because now I am really off to drive.
You said that last time.
Yes, I know. I do not think that Jorge does want to drive even more than those hours he's already done.
Okay, good luck.
So I'll see you guys in a couple hours then.
Enjoy. So as Rinus Jansens for Rare Endurance limps back to the pits in 11th position, he's the only P1 car that is not up with the rest of the other P1s, and he is 5 laps, soon to be 6 laps, behind the nearest P1 car. So I would say, what's that, 3, 6 times 3, about 18-20 minutes behind everyone else. He could almost run a English railway system. Oh, Kajmerik there, didn't quite know what to do. I do like the fact that you have phantom lights still. Wouldn't it be... Actually, it would probably be quite deadly, but if you did end up in R-Factor 2, excuse me, or other races, where you smash the front of your car and you lose the lights, and then you can't see anymore, I'd find that to be highly entertaining.
I would like that.
Yeah.
The GT2 is pretty much the kind of thing you want to use.
Really?
You may as well start killing.
Oh dear. So Jansen's there into the pits. Welcome back to the race, Nigel Middleton, in 13th position. Father or son, can't remember who's who. But it's nice to have a father-son hobby to do. What did I used to do with my dad that we'd do as a hobby? Bitch about mum? Not really sure. Yeah, that would be about it. I know, well, he used to quite like Sonic the Hedgehog. So we used to do Sonic. So then only if he could be Sonic and I could be Tails.
You should be Knuckles.
Ah, Sonic 3 that would have been though, wouldn't it? Was it Sonic 3 Knuckles came in? I can't remember.
Don't remember.
I have got on the PS2 actually like a Sonic collection game thing. It's pretty awesome.
I have it on the Xbox.
Ah. They keep re-releasing all the games in different formats.
Yeah.
So thankfully I've got the PlayStation Plus thing, so I got the Sonic 1 and 2 for free, which was quite awesome. So, but they play exactly the same because they've never been upgraded, it's just the same game that reappears. Quite like Sonic Generations actually that came out.
Yeah.
I think that gets unfairly bashed. In fact, I think Sonic as a whole gets unfairly bashed just because they've tried to make it 3D'd. Oh, Mark Urban off the track in 19th position, smacked into the wall. For 25 motorsports, not for the first time. See if I can get a replay of that. Excuse me, do apologise for my coughs. Doesn't look like I can get a replay of that. No. Never mind. But yeah, he just basically drove in too deep and just got two wheels on the grass, and that was the end of that. So, anyway. Top movie on IMDb, The Shawshank Redemption.
Never seen it.
It's a good film. I wouldn't say it was the best film ever. Then The Godfather. Then The Godfather Part 2, confirming the fact that sequels are never as good as the real one. Pulp Fiction. I've never seen Pulp Fiction.
That's quite a good film.
Is it?
Not the best, but quite good.
No.
The best movie ever.
No, yeah, Carl Urban smacked the barrier, so he's on his
Steve
way back.
Steve Davis is out of the game.
Oh! Collision detection. I think he needs... How would that have happened? Because he was driving earlier on perfectly fine, as Mark Urban pops into the pits to replace his rear wing. And that's allowed Robin Toll, I think, will go through at some point. Oh, he's really, really crawling. I think that's because Steve Davis hasn't got it.
Yeah, Mark Urban is waiting for Steve Davis to join in the car, I think.
What's he going to do? Will he go through and do another lap?
Has to drive another lap, I think.
Yeah, because it's going to take too long for him to reboot and rejoin. You just lose so much time. It's easier just to lose 15, 20 seconds driving through the pits and get going again. He rejoins his, that's Brandon Warren, just going through in 19th to lap Urban again. But Urban has dropped behind Robin Toll. Robin Toll is now up to second place for Rare Endurance Team in the GT2 class. So, all kicking off here at the back end of the field. Why would someone then suddenly have a mismatch, even though they didn't have one a few hours ago?
It's me.
The equation is a random artifact bug.
Is it? So you can literally just go back out and come back in and it could be fine?
Yeah.
Oh.
It's when you get HDB mismatches that they've obviously haven't them synced up or something.
Yeah, see, that one had an ALMS07 Acura ARX.HDV mismatch. That's strange, because I'd have thought he'd have had that earlier on. Let me just have a quick scroll up. Because Smolcheski had the same thing. Well, not the same, exactly the same, but yeah, well, never mind. Never mind. So, as he continues...
To the movies.
Yeah, back to the movies. Let's see who else. Let's just going to jump on board with the GT2s.
My favourite movie of all times is a movie that's been released in many languages.
Oh, the Bible.
No, it's not a movie. That's science fiction. Hinchcliffe.
What cliff?
Hinchcliffe. No, okay, Bible.
I don't
if you haven't heard of it, you are screwed.
Well, consider me screwed. I don't know what you're tell me more.
Norwegian, you can call it that. From the 70s?
I think.
70s, 80s. Must be 70s. But this bicycle repairman who builds his own car and drives a race and wins the race, of course.
Oh, wow. What was it called again?
In England, English, you call it Pinchcliffe.
Pinchcliffe. Right, that's going on my Amazon wishlist. Punchcliffe. Why can I not find it? Punch and Judy.
Try a search on YouTube. Might find it there.
Okay, I'll do that after the race. Oh, I'll have a little look.
Oh. The best if it's been filled by.
Probably not. You are foreign, so I may have just not quite got. Although I am foreign to you. So therefore, I probably have a stupid accent too.
Maybe.
My favourite film of all time is probably The Poseidon Adventure.
Oh, that's a good one.
The original, not the remake. So, just because I am a big fan of disaster movies, so I follow that one. Then followed by The Tower Inferno. Pretty good as well. Oh, off-road rally. Didn't work quite so well for Mark Urban there. He's got 2 laps before he gets caught by Marcel Vischer for Downforce Racing, so he can afford to just get this back. Not seen any more vehicle collision mismatches for Steve Davis, so hopefully he's got that sorted and can get back going again. Either that or they get the other driver in their team in and going again. So here he comes into the pits this time by. We'll soon see what happens as while that sorts itself out. Oh, that looked like a 6 minute pit stop there for someone. It's Sarusi Kiss Peter has disconnected. I'd have thought. Because look at that, 6 minute pit stop. I think we've got our next one.
He doesn't appear disconnected here.
No, he doesn't appear disconnected, but that's a 6.5 minute coming up, 7 minute pit stop.
Yeah.
So, not good. I'd say that they are next ones to go from this race, and that will drop us down to 23 teams.
I was pleased if it was 20 teams left when we got to the finish.
Well, we're still going. We're still on for it, aren't we? So it's not doing bad at all. Let's take a quick rundown of the order then, just as we approach the 4 hours to go mark. Excuse me, Rickard Helsen. Steve Davis has taken over that 05 car, by the way, now. So that appears to have worked fine. Rickard Helsen leads by 27 seconds, it says on there, but in my standings it says 1 minute 46. Slight difference for Turret Motorsports. Second is John Davies for Atlantic Racing Team. There he is. Well, there's a lot of trees, actually, to be honest, but there he is. It looked like one of those great panoramic shots that they do on nature discovery shows. Into the wild. Third?
The top of the tree.
Yeah.
He's angry! He's angry!
What do you watch?
Feed him the banana.
Jan Larsen, 05 Motorsports, P1 is third in the grid. Feed him the asparagus. Ooh, that was a close call for a lap there. In fact, Jan. Ooh, just about clinging on. Getting his old shaking my booty going. Fourth, Dimitri Buschka. Still going well for Ikuri Sim Motorsport. 3 laps off the lead. But fourth place is no mean feat, and I certainly wouldn't turn my nose up at one of those. Don't think I've ever had one of those. Who's in the pits?
Ford.
Ah.
Mr. Admin Director.
Ooh. I wouldn't go that far.
Good neighbor.
Neighbor. Neighbors become. Stefan Persson for Atlantic Racing is in 5th position. Leader of the P2 class, Brendan Kaczmarek, is in 6th place for R4R Motorsports. There he is, flying through the screen, 100 miles an hour. Attila Kish for Simco Hungarian is in 7th position. Magnus Dahlgren is in 8th place for ME Racing. 9th position for Kasper Mortensen for Team Tams International. Oh, Hodgewedge is out. For Rare Endurance in 11th place. Uh-ohs. And that's not Cerussi. So that's going to be another one that will join. Oh, he's crashed.
Oh.
It's not letting me replay it. That's a shame. But no, accident at lap 135. So that is proper barrier-tastic for Hodgewedge. It's not going back on a replay, I'm afraid, there, Mr. Blocker. That's not our fault, it's just the way how things are. But Hodgewedge is out. Let's see if we can... He might pop in to say hello. He does like a little bit of fun. Oh, thanks for that. Okay, I shall try and find that film, now that you've linked me into that. So, 10th position. Then for Andreas Loffler, currently 10 laps down for the Black Rebels. He is 11th now, retired as Jarno Hodgewedge. So 12th currently at the moment, although about to go into 11th, is Nigel Middleton for Total Sim Racing. 13th position is still this 10 minute pit stop for Cerussi Kispeter. I'm sure they're out. So that's a double whammy. 14th excuse me, for Roy and Mike Schroten for Team Schroten. 15th is David Gronvaus for SRH Zeno M. There he is coming through your screen. 16th for S. Ben Tipple, R4R Massive. Somehow that car is still going. I've never seen a car be so battered and bruised in its life, but it's kept going. 17th, and welcome to the race, Roy Magnes for really messed up interfer. Oh!
He's still looking at Sunrise.
Is he still watching the broadcast and that's why he got pimped? Look, it's me! No. Hey, mum!
Splat!
Yo, Simon!
Sunrise. Sun stuff.
Hey. Hi, guys.
It's Jarno!
Yeah!
What happened?
I lost the back. Bent on the glass.
And, did you find it?
Jumped into the wall.
Oh, what a shame, because he was just edging around the edges of the top 10 there, and obviously any finish is a good finish, but it would have been nice to see you get home.
Yeah, we in the preparation last week, we had, let's say, 2 good swaps, and then it went wrong. For about 3, 4, 5, 6 days in a row. And this time, today, it went okay. So we were glad to make it till the 8th hour. Just a minute later, I decided to hit the wall.
Never mind. But, well, it's been a season of up and downs for you. Any particular highlights, or...?
Today, to make it till the 8th hour. Had a lot of driver swap issues this season.
Yeah. It has been really unlucky for you, because normally we're so used to you being with Erwin. Sharing computers, and it's not so bad that way because you just have to rely on your own connection. But as soon as something else comes along, it's just not worked out for you.
Yep. Yeah. Better luck next season.
Will you be coming back for the 24-hour one?
Yeah.
Bay. That's what we like.
Yeah. We're there with I think 4 or 5 drivers, so let's win that one.
Awesome stuff. So. While you're here, I think Joachim and I need to ask you some questions.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Where were you last Monday between 5 o'clock and
it's just we've been told that someone was flashing around a little bit. So no. What's your favourite film of all time?
My favourite film of all time. Let's see, I think it's Fight Club.
Ooh.
Very.
That's all a bit ruffian.
It is.
Never mind. And favourite game? Aside probably from One Factor, although you must be hating it right now.
Yeah. I think it's FIFA 12, then. Besides all the racing games you play.
Ah, so you're not bad with your football games and stuff, so... Cool, okay. Do you buy a lot of the FIFA games, or do you just buy every couple of years?
I just own FIFA 12, that's the only one.
Okay. I was just going to ask you whether there is actually a point in buying each yearly update, because does anything really change? But if you've only got the one, then I suppose it's like, ooh, shiny new! So, not so bad.
It's strange how they don't just release updates for the FIFA series instead of a complete new game.
Well, I suppose they just want to milk the cash cow.
Yeah.
So, it's not bad at all. So, since, Yano, you've had such awful luck this year, we think that you should deserve to be the man who picks the first number for my takeaway bingo.
Are we going to get there? We're going to play bingo again, yeah?
Oh, yeah.
In a day.
Why not? So, if you could pick a number for me, go between 0 and 100, because any menu that I go through will have up to those numbers.
I think number 13 will do today.
13? Unlucky for some. Oh, God. Right, I'll jot down 13. I've not looked at what menu I'm going to go for, but I will promise I will pick number 13, whatever menu I'm going for. Thank you very much.
Mexican.
There isn't a Mexican round where I am, actually, I think. I could quite do with a Mexican. I could just do with food, really, to be honest.
Just start a Mexican.
Start a Mexican restaurant. I do a mean Mexican. I remember getting confused when I tried to make an Indian, but I didn't have any rice, so I'd done it with noodles, and I called it a Chindian. That was quite nice. So, are you handy cooking around the kitchen?
Who, me?
Yeah. Well, Yano.
A bit.
That sounds...
Not really.
Bombness.
Yeah.
Quite good with a toaster.
Not very confident.
Yeah, but like a microwave.
No problem. Is there anything else you'd like to add or subtract?
No, I think I go back to my team and apologise for ruining our race.
Well, it's a pleasure having you with us always. We'll look forward to seeing you back out on track for the 24-hour one next month.
Yeah, see you then.
Take care.
Okay, bye.
People were saying that George Talbot had crashed somewhere along the line, which may well be confirmed by the fact that he's pitting now.
He's limping into the piss.
Georgie Porgy. Is our admin man actually showing us how not to drive in the RT element? Leading by non-example. Excuse me. Fifth place on the all-time film rankings, The Good, the Bad and the Ugly.
Huh.
Westerns don't do it for me. 12 Angry Men, never seen that. Schindler's List.
Oh, that's a really good film.
Depressing.
Yeah, but it's good.
The Dark Knight. I didn't like The Dark Knight. I thought it was really overrated.
I enjoyed it.
It was a good film, but I bet no one else would have done it so much had Heath Ledger not died.
That's true.
I know that's really cynical to say. Welcome to the race, Kevin Brent. In 21st position, taking over the 25 motorsport car. Not 25, 05 motorsport car in 18th position. So George Toll obviously being told get the hell out of the cockpit.
For real anymore.
Yano's choice, Fight Club, is the 12th highest rated film on IMDb. Your film is rated 7.9 actually, so that's quite high. And that, see, it stopped it gives you the top 250 and that stops at 8. So yours isn't too far off the best films of all time.
But the problem there is it has been translated to so many movies in too many languages, so it's hard to find the best.
Okay.
I've seen the both the Norwegian and the English version, but Janos Pollock left the game.
Oh no! Janos. Oh, that'll be for Hell Racing Team Hungary, yeah, won't it? Yeah, they finally showed the DNF in 17th position.
Took some time.
It did. So kiss Peter there. Finally showing as a DNF. They've already slipped to 17th, and the Polish is now down to 12th with his accident. We're down to just 23 teams left now.
Reuters found out that he's going to cut the corners before start-finish line.
Uh-ohs.
Uh-oh, spaghetti-ohs.
Right, we've got our eye on you, Roy. George Talbot, as poor as his driving has been today, is not above getting out his admin whip and punishing people for penalties. And although Roy might probably like that, judging by the rumours that I've heard. We shall see. In fact, Roy, strangely, is on the same lap as the Schroten brothers, Grunvals, for SRH Zeno, and Tipple for Arthuron Massive. Those four drivers are all on exactly the same lap. So, there's hope for a battle for us yet. Because Kaczmarek and Kiss have not rejoined back up again after Kish's spin. There's still a good 20-odd seconds between them, and it's not really toing or froing, it's just staying quite static. And Grunvals is being closed down by Esben Tipple, who, when he's facing the right direction, is faster. So
strange.
And the Schroten brothers are the slowest of... are slower than Grunvals, but it's, again, Grunvals is facing the wrong direction quite often too, so proof that being a bit more cautious but actually staying in the right direction is good. So the bottom 100 movies as voted by our users with a rating of 1.3 is called Titanic: The Legend Goes On. Oh, it's an animated version of Titanic.
I actually think I've seen it.
I think I've got it on my wish list because I'm a disaster movie collector. Oh no! They try and Disney it. I'm drowning! I'm drowning! I love you!
Oh, I've the bottle!
Yeah.
What's inside this bottle?
Oh no, that's quite bad. Number two, although I'm now actually really wanting to see it because of the name, Super Babies, Baby Geniuses 2.
I've seen it.
Is it bad?
Yeah.
Oh, it looks like I really... That looks awful. I want to see that.
I remember seeing Super Babies 1 and thinking, oh my god, what is this crap? Children, I don't know, not children, babies, before they can speak, supposedly know all the secrets of the world. But the moment they learn how to speak, they forget all the info.
I've noticed at number 20, Fat Slags. I don't know if anyone ever read Viz magazine, but they made a film out of it and it looks bloody awful, so never mind. I'm just trying to see. It says, The Apocalypse. Have a look at that. That looks awful. I'll probably like that. Just try to see if there's any films that I might know about, or that people in general. Epic Movie.
Oh, 68. Yeah.
I've got that. It's awful.
Funny. It's funny.
It's, you know, when things are so bad they become good again.
Yeah.
Troll 2. I'm sure that's on YouTube as one of those ones where it's like the worst scream ever in a film, and he goes, "Oh no!" Makes me look like I can act.
There was this movie called The Troll Hunter or something.
That's it. Yeah, and because that's only just come out, and I quite fancy the look of that.
That's a Norwegian movie.
Yeah, yeah. Have you seen it?
Yeah, I have it on my computer.
Do you recommend it?
Yeah.
I'm sure that was digitally downloaded in a legal fashion.
Yeah.
Because you must keep... Yeah. You must keep everything alive in the film industry because they don't already make enough money as it is.
But that is a really good movie.
It's too what is? What, Troll Hunter?
Yeah.
Really? Because what other... Is there a big Norwegian film that everyone would know about?
Ellie? When you have the Pinchcliffe movies, most of the people of the world know about them.
Well, I'm going to know about them shortly.
Other Norwegian movies people should know. Roy, any suggestions?
Don't talk to me, I'm driving.
Here on the wood. I don't know, I don't know. Thank
you. Ryan Mayfield's back in the 05 car in third position. So that's looking good for him. Tim Brooke is defending, actually, FIFA games, saying that the whole tackle system changed between 11 and 12.
Yeah.
No idea, no idea. I remember playing sensible soccer.
Oh, Espen Tippel spun off the track.
Oh, where is he? 16th now, isn't he?
16th, Roy just passed him.
Not quite facing the right way. Oh, now he is now. As he comes into view, is all of his car intact? It is just about.
He was facing the wrong way when Roy passed him. So.
Yeah, and Roy's gone up into 15th position. So that's a change of hands there. So Espen Tippel, he said he's been disappointed with himself when he came in to chat to us. And then proceeded to go on about his semen. So I suppose it was all downhill, really. And now it's been a slippery slope.
Yeah, that car's quite twitchy.
It does look twitchy, actually. Wonder if it's just a setup problem that it just once it's dialed in, it gets a little bit better. But who knows?
I feel sorry for that camera movement. It just went to a tree.
Troll Hunter. 2012 Doomsday sucked. Yes, it did, Dave Simmons. I've got that on DVD. Bloody awful as well.
2012 movie?
Yep, I thought that was a really lazy film, actually. Because it's just exactly the same thing happening over and over, and special effects do not make a film. As much as people would like to think so, it doesn't.
Best part of that movie was the crazy dude with the camper van.
Dear. Right. What shall I have? Shall I have Chinese? Actually, I don't think I fancy Chinese today. I'm quite fancy an Indian. Who's that chatting away?
Come on, Sharda.
Oh, best game ever is Metal Gear Solid, says Simon Melkowish.
No. I approve on that, actually. But, Solid Snake is good game developer, so...
Yeah, I mean, they are good games, actually. I tell you what I did do for my YouTube channel. I done a poll where people submitted their top 20 PS1 games, and Metal Gear Solid absolutely topped the list on that by a long way. So, obviously people are very, very fond of it.
Only bad about Metal Gear Solid if you shoot lights, no one sees you. You can stand next to the guard and you don't know you're there.
Oh well. They might know I'm there if I eat an Indian tonight. I do quite fancy an Indian. I did have a takeaway last week. Oh, this is bad news. Where shall I go?
What kind of takers do you have nearby?
I've got a couple of Indians, a couple of Chineses, a couple of pizza places.
Have a Latvian?
Sorry?
We have a Latvian?
No.
Because what? They have a really good dinner. Not dinner, but local food.
Oh, okay.
Good food.
What is it?
Don't ask me to say what it is, but I don't know. I've only been in Riga 3 times, so. But last time I was there, we ate at some local with local Latvian food.
Mm.
It was really, really good.
Cool. I'm going to Google Latvian food now. Let's see. You should never do this to me, because otherwise I would just eat. Latvian food. Latvian grey peas and ham. Ew. Surely grey peas were green peas that have just gone off. Caraway cheese? Oh, I don't know. I do
Someone
like.
Someone doesn't understand that they should pass Roy when he's given a move.
Grand Vows there in the pits from 13th place. Roy looks like he's about to move up.
Yeah. Someone spun in the behind of Roy after hitting him in the back when he was giving a move.
Whoops. Can't quite see anyone facing the wrong way at the moment. Roy.
True. Roy could be.
Roy Magnus goes up into 13th because he's beaten
Grunberg.
Oh, what, Stefan Persson?
Might be.
Or John Davies, actually.
Right.
Either or. Because we're starting to get a little bit of dawn hitting the skies now, aren't we? It's looking like a morning glory, and no, not that type. People still got their lights on.
Not that dark, actually, now.
It's really not, is it? It's... Oh, Casper Mortensen has had an engine failure in 9th position. Uh-oh, let's see if I can... The Thames International.
Ugh. There's always something about Thames.
Once again, it's not letting me do a replay. This is annoying.
Press R?
No, yeah, it's stuck on the screen.
Choose the right screen.
Oh, no, it's, yeah, it's just, it's not seeing it, if it knows what I mean. It just stays like it's in the garage, as if it can't pick it up. But an engine failure for Casper Mortensen for Thames International, out from 9th position. Kaczmarek has just been passed by Attila Kish. What's going on there? Is Kaczmarek in trouble? Ah, no, it's recorrected itself now. Kaczmarek is now back ahead of Kish. It's just, that was a lag issue there. So, Loeffler in the pits. Now down to just 21 teams left. So, dropping like flies. Still got 3.5 hours left to go. I hope that's not still the same people in that Ferris wheel as they were several hours ago, otherwise they would be desperate for the loo.
What about the Zeppeliner?
Yeah. So, not good going on there. We don't have any good restaurants, actually, in Harlow. We used to have a little... Indonesian-y one that was quite funky, but that didn't last very long because I think everyone went, ugh, not doing Indonesian. So, let's see. Okay.
How about Turkish?
Isn't that just kebab?
No, they have plenty other foods.
A kofti kebab.
Don't have this soup with some big meatballs.
That's like IKEA.
No, not IKEA. I actually never went to IKEA.
No. Yeah, I wouldn't recommend it unless you want flat pack furniture galore. I know what you mean now, that's going to really annoy me. Hello Google. Come off of Latvian cuisine off Wikipedia. So if, in fact, this could be a disaster, because I've just googled Turkish meatballs, so I could just get something very disturbing on my screen. Oh no, it's just called coffee meatballs. Okay. But I know what you mean, there is it's like a delicatessen of it, isn't it? So
we had Turkish restaurants in where we live.
It lasts okay.
For about half a year. They burnt it down.
Oh. Left the meals in a little bit too long, did they?
No, there was this insurance fraud.
Okay. That's not good.
No. It's actually quite bad because they had good food.
Ah. Mind you, I remember the best Chinese takeaway that I ever had. I ended up, it got shut down because it used to have cockroaches running about in it. And it never actually had a food hygiene certificate the entire 4 years it ran there, but it was still the nicest one ever. Which probably says more about my taste for food than anything else. A little bit of dirt won't hurt.
3 second rule?
Yep. I'm so glad that other people have about as little morals for food off the floor as anyone else.
As long as it's in your own home. Mm. Your family people has been there.
Dear. Right. I can't decide what I'm going to eat. I think I will go for an Indian. Let's have a look. Pick a number between 19.
Banana?
Don't give me a banana fritter. Yes. 19 and
133.
111. Oh. That seems relatively normal. I almost sound disappointed. Okay. Right. You've given me a chicken tikka boona.
I don't know what that is.
it's quite mild, actually. And Jarno done 13, and that's an onion bhaji. The problem is, I now need another dish because it's not quite got to £9 for me to get free delivery. So I now need... I will need a side dish between the numbers... Oh, someone's just messaged me. Go on then, Oscar. 42. What have we got? Since Oscar has sat there patiently from the beginning.
Chicken, Oscar's coming with us.
Chicken cashmere. Mild and fruity. I don't know what that is.
Just like you. Is that,
a sexual curry? God. Oh, wow. Esben Tipple, they're just leaving the pits.
Mild and fruity. did he leave pits without the fungus?
Yeah. It looks like it, yeah.
You forgot something, Esben?
Not going well. Kevin Ledoux is back in the Black Rebels P2 car in 9th position. Yeah, I think he's obviously trying to go for the old, I'll get the straight line speed. Of course, Ryan Mayfield's
who needs corners? We spin and anyways.
Who needs downforce? In fact, don't go to Oscar Hardwick's for dinner, he has a 10-second wall.
Ah, that's good.
Okay, let's try Oscar. 42.
That's the floor number, it's okay for me.
Ooh, see, I'm going to offer you a potential buyout. Oscar put in a couple of numbers, and his could prove more entertaining, because one of them is a prawn vindaloo. And Vindaloo's are going to be very hot, so you might hear me crying a little bit on air. What's 101 actually, for that matter? Oh, chicken tikka danzak. Oh no, that's lentils. Lentils are minging. I don't know.
You can't switch out the 13 number then.
No, 13 is...
So, you missed.
Well, 13 is a starter, so I feel it's only fair to have a starter.
Yeah.
If I'm going to go down, I'm going to go down properly.
Copper Mortens and I left the game. That's a while ago.
There it is. His engine blew up quite a bit ago. Yeah. Steve Davis is back in the 05 motorsport car.
I'm working in first angle now.
Hmm?
Roy is right behind him.
Ah.
We can see him.
Let's get some onboard shenanigans while we just run through the order on your screen. So I was getting a bit lax on the camera angles because I was busy looking at what dinner I should order. So, apologies with that. So, okay, final decision then down to you. Should I go for the Chicken Tikka Puna or a Chicken Cashmere, which is the fruity one, or the blindingly hot Prawn Vindaloo?
Right, 1, 2, or 3.
Yeah, 1, 2, or 3. 2.
You've
gone for the fruity.
Suits you then.
Suits you, sir.
Roy's about to go up on the side of Steve Davis and say,
"Hello. How you?
How you doing? Wow. There he goes.
And then."
Hello. Right, I think then. There's a young in Bargee and a chicken cashmere, and it comes to £6, so I need another £3, so I think I shall choose my own side dish. I'm really hungry now. Oh, come on. I'm 30p short of delivery.
Told her.
Yeah. No, I'll go for... Well, I haven't ordered a rice. That might be why.
How much just delivery?
Free if I spend more than £9. So I feel that ordering an extra dish is worthwhile. I'm such a fat boy. Fried rice, I've never had that before. Right, ordered.
Hello?
Oh yes. Justeat.co.uk rules the world.
So if I order in your name, you get the food?
if you use my login, yeah.
Hold on. There's a ton of food.
Yeah, but hello!
It was a delivery!
Yeah. John Van Der Geest says, are there any instances of people falling asleep on the long straights?
Well, come on.
There is Mr. Helson on board as we see daybreak.
Shoot. And three. Over at C0. Because then you can speed.
Okay. If anyone wants to know where I ordered from, just to check its authenticity, it's the... If you go to justeat.co.uk, it's called the Indian Balti Express in Harlem. So you can check that I have actually ordered the numbers that people have shouted at me. So. All good fun.
How can we check the order of the numbers we say? We can't go home to you and see.
I know, but I'm calling out what...
No.
You have to trust me with that one. Nom 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 nom. Oh, what was that? Is that someone stopped on the straight?
That was Tipple.
Was that Mr. Tipple? Not quite.
I think it was.
What's we got to these days? 17? 14, 15? Watch Ridge's out. S. Miller?
Yeah, that's the same car.
Welcome to the race, Stephen Miller. You've not got very far. I think, John, you have found the first person to fall asleep on a long straight.
Hello? Hello?
I'm going to tap my monitor.
It's in gear.
Cooey.
One.
Everyone push, or everyone blow at the screen on three.
At least you can put on lights, because that one came suddenly.
Oh dear. Come on. I'm going to leave it on there, just because I really do feel that someone is going to smack it at some point.
Yeah. They're all in traffic in four cars now, and they're going down the straight now.
Oh,
Ben Warren, get on the right side, get on the right side. This is good. Bad.
Oh dear. Stephen Miller, if it's not going to work, you need to exit out, mate. Either that, or maybe he's unplugged his wheel or something. Yeah. In which case, use the keyboard. Keyboard is your friend.
Right.
I tell you what is also your friend. The escape button.
Yeah.
The escape button. Here comes the Schroten. And they go up.
Oh,
Gronvals and Blocker were side by side going through that. They must have, well, left a trail of doo-doo behind them. Because that would have been close. Oh well. Ooh. While we're watching that, I'll just run the stand-ins across the screen. People said they wanted some static shots. I'll give you one. There we go. There is everyone. Mortensen, of course, engine failure. Out there. Hodgewood is out, of course, crashed. Kiss disconnected. I think we're going to have another retirement for R4R Massive. That car cried enough, possibly.
Come on.
Exactly. Oscar. Coochie coochie goo. He was a clever boy, then. He was a clever boy.
You could tape a carrot stick on the front windshield, maybe he'll drive.
Oh, Oscar, by the way, yes, you can come in and chat. I've only just seen your little text thing. Yeah, do pop in and say hello.
I've said it earlier, you can join if you want to.
Yeah, I know. It's our party. Yeah. Neil Tasker says he's probably popped for a toilet break in the hedge. Somebody pass him some toilet roll.
Yeah.
Oh wow. And there you can see the last lap times by for everyone, and we'll continue. I'll just keep scrolling, and I'm sure he'll conk out soon enough. In fact, let's just come off of that now, because I think everyone's now aware, so I don't think people will crash into him. There is our race leader there for thingy. So,
and
we have a guest.
Welcome, Oscar Hardwick.
Hello.
How's you doing?
I'm not doing too bad, thanks. It's been quite a long race. I rarely watch these endurance races. I'm either commentating on them or think, gosh, that goes on for a long time, so I'll do something different. But I've been watching this one, and it's been really, really... It's been quite good and entertaining. There's been the odd battle and people going off every few metres, so definitely worth a watch.
Good stuff, and you've kept me thoroughly entertained with your chat in the chat box. Much appreciated. So I think it's time to share some of your views on the world now, because you were chatting about, you seem quite knowledgeable with lots of games and films and stuff, so I'm quite interested to hear bits and bobs.
I only sound quite knowledgeable because stuff that I knew came up. That doesn't mean that I know very much.
Doesn't matter. It's like multiple choice questions. They're only not difficult if you already know the answer.
Okay.
says I.
Right, fire away, see what happens if I come up with an intelligent answer.
We're not asking for that, but no, it says... we were talking earlier on about favourite games?
Yes.
Fire away.
I guess I could start with sim racing games, seeing as that's, you know, roughly on topic, and then we can veer away ever so gradually.
Okay. ever so gradually as in, this was the time when I'd done a 2D platform pixelated mess.
Want to bam?
Something along those lines, yeah. I still really enjoy Live for Speed, I'll be honest.
Okay.
I always find myself going back to it. I've many a time said, okay, I won't do any more Live for Speed because there seems to be more going on with other sims, and then I end up back there a few weeks later.
What brings you back?
I guess just the people around there, because that's where I started off, so I know them a bit better. But I've been at Race Park for a long time now. I do lots of Richard Burns Rally and think that's fantastic.
Yeah, that doesn't get enough loving, does it, Richard Burns Rally, does it? Really?
It doesn't. But, you know, the Race Park Rally Championship's going strong. I forget how many sign-ups they got last season, but it was literally some.
Hmm. Okay. But it doesn't matter, so long as the competition is good.
Yeah, well, that's what everything that I've done has been pretty good.
Excellent. So what about non-sim racing then?
Non-sim racing. I really like...
Brendan.
Is it Shank? It was a...
Oh yeah.
It was on one of the indie bundles while ago. And I picked it up and I think that's just brilliant. And then obviously earlier on I was raving about Psychonauts and Double Fine. They make games that got good stories. I mean, if you're the sort of person that goes, oh, I want graphics and Battlefield 3, then please don't go near them because you'll hate every second. But, you know, I don't mind what the game looks like, really. I'm not into that.
No.
Brilliant.
We go for story, gameplay and entertainment value.
Yeah, I mean, I'll even buy a completely terrible game if it's bad enough to be entertaining.
Oh, yeah. Because some of my favourite games are some of the ones that are the most flawed, but they're still entertaining to play.
Yeah, I mean, I love some of the like later Ace Combat games that are on consoles.
Hmm.
And they didn't get any love, and people who played the earlier ones said they were terrible. But I think they're great, and enjoy them. The voice acting could have been done better by members of my own family, but... They're really enjoyable games.
Aww. See, what are you? I've got a few of the Ace Combat ones. I think I've got. Is it the Balkan or not Balkan?
Yeah, the
ones and stuff.
I've still got that one, and I think it was Ace Combat 5 before that that I really enjoyed.
Squadron Leader and Distant Thunder. I've got.
Might be Squadron Leader. I wouldn't be able to tell you.
No probs. But you give them a thumbs up.
Oh, definitely. If anyone still owns a PlayStation 2, which I believe is what they're on, then you know, go and pick it up.
Have you played the latest Ace Combat? Because it tried to go all like theatrical, and it seems to have really divided people.
What was that one called again?
I don't know, actually, to be honest. But it's
having a go on it, but I've not played it through or anything like that, so. I don't want to give an opinion, or have one probably, because I like the ones I played, so I'll stop there and quit whilst I'm ahead.
Awesome. And what about your most obscure gaming passion that you have, if you have one?
Magicka is good. I've not got anywhere on the game because I'm still finding interesting ways to kill myself. I've played it for about 11 hours over the last month, and I'm still just putting in new combinations to see the most entertaining way in which I can commit suicide. I don't think I'm anything past the second level in the game, but no, that's fantastic, and like more for its comic value than anything else.
Mm.